The time now is 12:45 of 24th of October 2013. The 9th Ordinary Council Meeting, Annual and Annual Debate of the Hong Kong University Student Union Council Session 2013 is start now. Will all council please stand? In the first part of our council meeting, the council will sing the union song first before the council meeting commences. So now we are going to sing the union song.
Maximum intake of the non-local
applicants is just the starting point to let the councillor to investigate on the problem of the mechanism of the admission of non-local students to the HKU. And there are some issues that will be discussed today, like the mainland student to the other, to the student from the other countries, the ratio will be evaluated, and the universal resources and government resources to those non-local students and local students will also be an issue to evaluate. And today, we are very glad to invite representative from the university, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Professor Roland Chin. Registrar, Mr. Henry Wang. Dean of Students Affairs, Dr. Albert Chow. To join our discussion to make our discussion more fruitful. And the language used in this council meeting will be both Chinese and English, since Chinese and English are both enjoy equal status in the HKUSU. And I will hold the meeting in English. However, since my proficiency of English is not that good, and by the meantime, when I need to facilitate the discussion, I may use Chinese to facilitate the discussion. And for counselor and other union full member, you can use either Chinese and English whenever it deems fit, since it's enjoyed the equal status in the HKUSU. And for members who don't understand Chinese, you can obtain the translation equipment from the back side of the venue, because we have instant translator provided orally and in word form. And the word form will be provided in the Google document posted in the Facebook venue. Thank you very much. And since this topic is quite controversial, and I hope that many different people may have their different opinion, and we hope that everyone can respect each other's opinion in this council meeting. And thank you very much. And now we'll enter to the section agenda A1 to read out the correspondence of the councillor. Various councillor will be absent from this council meeting. First, Financial Secretary Ho Yiman Human will be absent in this council meeting due to work. Student Welfare Secretary Choi Hong Kong Ryan will be absent due to lesson. Publication and Publicity Secretary Leung Ah Man will be absent due to tutorial. And Editor-in-Chief Leung Kai Ping will be absent due to sickness. And the following councillor will be late for the council meeting. Popularly elected Union Councillor for Soul Check Yu will be late for 15 minutes due to transportation problem. Oh, he's arrived now. Okay. And for representative of the Simon KY Lee Hall will be late due to scheduled presentation in class. And the following councillor will early leave the council meeting. Representative of Cultural Association 1, Conway Tan Cafe, will be early leave at 1:45 due to personal matters. Representative of the Hornell Hall will early leave at 1:30 due to family issues. Representative of Dental Society, Liu Qinghan Eric, will early leave at 1:30 since he needs to catch a flight of his overseas study tour. Any other correspondence? If no, we will go to section agenda A2 to report the motions carried by circulation. Since from this last council meeting till now, I didn't receive any motion carried by circulation, and there is no motion we have in this council meeting. However, I need to remind all hall representatives to propose the motion by circulation on your hall orientation reports. Yeah, because I remember some of you have already done but didn't submit the motion. Okay, so we'll go down to agenda A3 to receive and adopt the agenda. We can see from the agenda that today we will have two things to discuss. One is the annual debate, and the other one is to endorse the press statement. 香港大學生會停止黑箱作業立即開誠布公，履行公正程序，確保廣播自由聲明 issued by the Current Affairs Committee HKUSU Council Section 2014, date 18 October 2014. And we will have this agenda since from the bylaws, we need to endorse the statement in the coming council meeting after the issue of press statement. So is there any problem?No. Motion on table. The time now is 12:56 of 24th October 2013. The motion that to receive and adopt the agenda of CM9, proposer 10 Lawrence at law, seconder Wong Yi Man. In the restrooms, proposer and seconder. If not, any consultation, discussion, amendment, objection?If no, motion carried. So now is the agenda A4. Agenda A4. To receive and adopt the minutes of CM8. And councillor can receive the CM8 minutes online. And so, councillor have any question on?The CM8 minutes. If no, the time now is 12:57 of the 24th October of 2013. The motion that to receive adopt the agenda, the minutes of CM8. Proposer Wong Yi Man, seconder Tan Lawrence, Yap Long. Any question, seconder?Okay. If no, any consultation, discussion, amendment, objection? If no, motion carried. So now we are entering the agenda B1.To hold the annual debate topic, the maximum intake of non-local applicants to HKU should be reduced. 香港大學收生應調低非本地生限額。And councillor can see the opinion of the other councillor in the annual debate booklet. And I can see that their views are very controversial because I see many councillors agree, but there are also many councillors oppose the motion.And however, the issue they investigate are similar. So maybe now I will let you guys let councillor to have the first round speech first. Each councillor will have 1 minute and 30 seconds to express your view towards the issue. And when there are 30 seconds left, and I will put it up. And if there's 10 seconds left, I'll put it up. And if it's already over 1 minute and 30 seconds, I will stop you immediately.Any other problem? If no, any councillor will express their view towards the issue. Do there any councillor for this motion? You can express your view for.Any councillor?Agree with this motion. Representative of St. John's College, a student association, Wong Shi Kei.
Thank you, Chairperson. The reason that why I for this motion is.Mainly concerning the allocation of resources, that I think that now resources is very limited in HKU. For example, the vacancies in residential colleges and halls. And before the, I know that the university is going to extend, maybe build two more colleges in the coming years, but I don't think that it can accommodate the non-local students now that some of the non-local students have to live in some flats in Taiwan, and local students may not get their rooms or have their resources in whole according to the resources now. So I think in this moment, when the university doesn't have enough resources to accommodate all the students' needs, to cater all the students' needs, then the priority should be given to local students first, and they can't should not given the priority to non-local students. So this is maybe the main reason why I think that the maximum intake should be reduced. Thank you.
Any other opinion? Okay, representative of Law Association, Lee Chi Wen.
Thank you, Chairman. I'm for this motion because as we see from the figures, there are in the 10 past years, the non-local students has been increased by 5 times while the local students has increased for 10% only. And the proportion of the increase is very uneven, that the resources is not put in to the local students like the ordinary Hong Kong people. And of all the 20% of the newly admitted students, 4% is funded by the government, which is using the resources of Hong Kong citizens, which we pay by tax. I do agree that we should have more local students in the university to enrich the university life and to have more cultural exposure for all students, but then I don't agree that we should use the resources provided by Hong Kong citizens to subsidize the non-local students in Hong Kong. I think the percentage of the government-funded places for non-local students should be reduced to reallocate the resources to increase the proportion of local students who can be admitted into the university now. Thank you.
Representatives of Arts Association, welcome. Can I share your wireless mic around? You can use it for your speech.
Right. 多謝主席，大家好，文許學生會代表，原諒我用中文發言，因為比較容易表達我嘅睇法。首先我係 against 個 motion 嘅，我認為呢個 motion 係不應該成立嘅。嗱，首先喺講話即係 against 個 motion 嚟對啦，首先希望大家明白啲 keyword 先，非本地生 OK 有內地生，有海外生，希望大家明白呢樣嘢。第二限額，限額咧，我哋而家非本地生限額咧應該係20% 嘅。 咁而限額亦同學額唔同喎，因為限額20%入面咧有分咗16% 咧係冇受政府資助學額，即係當然都有政府部分資助啦，但係唔係全額資助。另外有4% 咧係政府全額嘅資助學額嘅。咁而呢20% 入面其實得4% 咧係先會同咧一個即係一般 JUPAS 入學嘅學生咧係有一個分學位嘅，大家可以理解為一個雙軌嘅入學制。 咁所以另外大部分16% 其實都唔會影響即本地學生入學。咁剛才首先回應翻一啲評議員提到嘅論點先。第一樣嘢 resources allocation， 究竟我哋而家調低非本地生限額，係咪就可以俾到多啲 resources 俾我哋嘅本地生咧？嗱，大家可以睇下而家非本地生咧，其實佢佔嘅比例咧係15.5%，而個限額係20%，即係話你就算減低咗限額都冇用。 因為而家根本就非本地生嘅限額根本就未爆喎，所以你就算減低咗嗰15.5%， 即係當你減低咗17% 啦，都仲係有15.5% 嘅作用。咁同埋我認為，即係如果你用資源分配呢樣嘢，就即係嚟削弱我哋即係廣大國際化呢一個即係優勢啦。我認為唔係幾一個 valid reason 咯，即係我會覺得係有非本地生係對我哋廣大國際化一樣好重要。 咁當然個問題就係話，究竟係咪可以有非本地生就有多啲國際化呢？記住剛才有講到非本地生都有分內地生啊嘛。如果你睇翻呢15.5% 嘅非本地生咧，其實佢嘅比例咧入邊有10% 嘅比例都係內地生嚟嘅。咁係一個比較即係不 even 嘅比例啊。如果我哋講國際化，而 家基本上是一個內地化，而正正就是大學咧，其實都是提倡呢樣嘢嘅喎。大學話咧就要 50% 係非本地生，50% 咧係要內地生。咁當然而家係超過咗 50% 嘅比例啦。咁上網睇新聞咧，亦都見到教務長竟然曾經講過話，其實咧希望
唔好意思，唔係家同學，嗰、那個一分半鐘嘅發言時間已經過咗，你會唔會有十秒鐘嘅時間俾你去？
咁總言之，我會覺得係我哋唔應該咧係調低非本地生限額，而即係當然資助下已經唔應該調低就再槍破啦。但係20% 限額咧，其實我哋唔應該調低嘅。而大家關鍵即係要諗嘅關鍵就係究竟我哋廣大變咗內地化嘅大學，定係國際化嘅大學？
Thank you, Chairman. I would also like to show my opinion that I'm against this motion. The first reason behind my stance is because I think actually the international students or the non-local applicants towards Hong Kong U is actually beneficial to the local applicants as well. As we can see from many like academic activities or in lessons or tutorials, the non-local students' opinions are actually quite inspiring. Just like sharing from my own opinion, from my own experience, from my tutorials, actually the international students are able to analyze or to explain to us what they're having or what they are facing in their own country. And this is very beneficial to Hong Kong students who has not had a very all-round experience in the globe. And I would also like to say that when we are considering to lower the quota of the non-local applicants, we should consider that whether the interest or whether the supply or demand of every other parties has changed. But I don't see such a change, so I don't think we should lower the quota. Thank you.
Representative
of University Hall Student
Association, 何
春天。請各位原諒我用中文去發言，多謝主席。其實我就對呢條辯題的立場就是我是支持的，但 是首先講自己的論點先啦。其實簡單嚟講就係、我同意本地生非本地生咧可以幫助到我哋去充實我哋嘅大學生活，亦都好能夠提升我哋國際化嘅地位嘅。但係咧，其實非本地生佢本身佢留港工作嘅人數係非常之少嘅，再加上本地嘅人才係非常之短缺啦。即係我諗呢一個大家都必須要面對嘅現實嚟嘅，就係、其實香港咧其實好少人可以入到學啫，得18% 可以升到上大學。其實呢一點政府係需要正視嘅。咁另外回應翻你話啊減低咗學額，咁即係減低咗限額，但係其實而家未爆喎。咁但係你睇翻過去咁多年，其實非本地生嘅人才不斷咁上升。其實佢會超過呢一限啦，可以話指日可待。咁另外咧就係、咁，所以我哋就係要減低一限啦，希望佢可以減少同本地生嘅競爭，同埋可以減低即係呢一個資源分配，即、就、係、是、我認為資源錯配啦。咁最後一點咧就係、我亦都好同意剛才吳慧嘉議員所講到嘅嘢、就是，即係其實而家非本地生裏面嘅比例都相之唔平衡啦，即係有超過一半係內地生嘅，即係有接近超過一半係內地生咁樣。咁其實到底香港大學收咁多非本地生翻嚟，係要佢國際化，因為內地化嘅話，呢、一個其他議員都可以發表成講下自己的意見啦。多謝主席。
Thank you, Chair. Regarding this issue, I do support this motion, although I have no vote for it. I agree with the University Board representative that the ratio between the Chinese students and international students is of utter importance in this issue. The university now have the regulations of having the ratio set in half and half, but it's not enforced. So I recommend this regulation to be strictly enforced to avoid any imbalance between, within the non-local students pool, so that our so-called internationalization will not be lopsided into too much of feminization. However, I would like to also address on the postgraduate intake of Hong Kong youth. Nowadays in Hong Kong, over 70% of the postgraduate intake is from the mainland China, which is, shows a heavily imbalanced in intake. And this heavily reduces the chance for local applicants to enter academia. The intake itself sometimes determined by professors. However, the universities, I don't mean only by Hong Kong U, but all universities in Hong Kong do have the responsibility to check and to protect the rights of local graduates to have, to ensure they do have enough chance to develop their potential in academia. Our policies, and I want to also address about the why the government, why the local quota doesn't increase for so many years. Today, okay. So, you have too many private institutions providing degrees, so I do recommend to reduce the quota for mainlanders, both in undergraduates and postgraduates. Thank you.
We have last two opinion can be provided by councillor. Which two councillors want to talk? Okay. Maybe president and representative of the education side. Okay. President.
其實想回應翻啦，點解自己個人係反對呢個辯題嘅？第一點就係針對住話。現在非本地生是受住香港政府或者香港大學的資助呢，其實這個的確是事實，但其實非本地生比起本地學生比的學費都是高很多的。我們每個學生一年學費是12萬，但是其實4萬一年，但是其實非本地生比的是一年10萬的。雖然其實每一個 undergraduate 學位的成本是大概25萬的香港大學，其實我自己就 propose 除了可以即除了考慮話減收本地生之外，其實可以考慮翻去增加翻非本地生的學位，從而去即平衡翻話用緊納稅人的錢或者香港大學的錢去資助緊。非本地生，其實睇翻，其實香港大學是有空間去調升學費的。比較翻亞洲鄰近地方的學費咧，其實新加坡一個學士學位大概是要83萬，日本就是要80萬，就算馬來西亞都要54萬嘅。其實比起香港嚟講，其實香港都係好平。咁我自己又覺得係仲有空間去加翻學費，或者就住唔同嘅科目去跟翻成本去 charge 翻 non-local students 去 compensate 翻嗰個即係資助嗰個效應嘅。至於同埋有同學即係都會去 challenge 呢個大陸生同埋overseas students 嘅50-50呢個比例，其實即係我自己都認同嘅。不論黑貓定白貓，總之捉到老鼠就好貓啦。即係其實無論你係咩國籍都好，你只要有一定學術水平，你都應該可以入到大學，唔應該有一個比例限制啦。但係我哋要認清個事實，究竟香港大學係咪能夠即係收到喺全世界收到唔同國家？一個相等比例的同學入嚟咧，即大家睇翻，可能喺大陸、中國大陸嚟講，香港大學對佢哋嚟講已經係一個最好嘅 option。但睇翻 overseas 美國、英國的高中生嚟講，香港大學未必對你 first preference 嚟喎。所以我哋如果要維繫翻一個高學術水平，係無可避免要收翻一定數量的大陸生咯。如果想有一個平衡的收生，有唔同嘅國籍，我哋自然。一定要將香港大學更加提升到即係國際嘅一級水準，好似哈佛、斯丹福咁樣，咁自然全世界嘅大學生、全世界嘅同學都會上嚟香港讀大學咯。多謝主席。
The last council representative of Education Society 吳志軒。
多謝主席。咁其實我覺得睇翻呢條辯題啦，咁大家討論嘅位都係在於點解要調低我哋呢一個。非本地生限額，咁其實我覺得大家最主要嘅抗爭位都係在於點解我哋而家喺first year intake 入邊，我哋嘅 local students 係咁少，即係不足20%。咁其實我覺得成個討論嘅位係在於到底我哋本身本地生係咪應該加翻一啲學位俾我哋自己嘅本地生咧？ 咁當然我睇到即根據教資會資助嘅數據嚟講啦，咁其實喺由2008年去到2013年間，佢哋嘅資助就係喺非本地生佔整體學生嘅數目嚟講咧，就係由11.6%去到12.7%，去到13.5%，去到14.2%，再到14.5%，即其實一路增加咗嘅。咁但係其實政府對於高等教育嘅資助咧，其實就係由2008年嘅1.38%咧跌到去2012年嘅1.2%喎。咁即係其實喺我哋非本地生比例高咗嘅時候，點解我哋本地生所享受嘅高等教育嘅資助係會少咗咧？咁其實我覺得大學嘅國際化同收生呢樣嘢咧係冇衝突，可以相關並行嘅。首先第一點就係，其實只要我哋嘅政府可以提供翻足夠嘅資源俾高等教育，去保障翻我哋本地生嘅升學率嘅話，根本上可以係吸納多啲唔同來自世界各地嘅同學，因為大學國際化係可以提供到我哋思想同埋學術上面嘅交流，喺唔同文化同唔同背景之下。咁所以我嘅立場就係覺得喺今次辯題入邊，我哋應該係要求佢政府去提高呢一個嘅對於高等教育喺本地生入邊資助，而係去調低非本地生嘅限額。多謝。
So now end the first section of Councillor's speech. Okay, so now may we invite our representative of the university to express their opinion towards the issue and or any response to our councillors. Okay, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Professor Rochi.
Thank you for inviting us. I guess our role in the university is not to engage in this debate. We are here to provide information because the debate should be held by the students. Listening to all the good comments, either for or against, a few points I very agree. In that, I think as a society, we only take in 18% of the high school graduates could be increased so that we can provide better, more places for students who does not have that opportunity. That's my first point. The second point that many of you has mentioned about the 50-50, out of the 20%, 50% should be mainland students and 50% should be overseas. The university is working very hard to achieve that. We have colleagues, our staff around the world recruiting students. So we are trying to meet the target, but it could not be met overnight. So we gradually will want to meet that target, which is the policy target of the university. The third point I want to make is tuition. The fees that we are charging for non-local students might have some room to increase. And by increasing that fee, more resources can be put into the university as a whole. And I don't believe that resources should be separated in that you are local student, then you get more resources. You are non-local student, you get less resources. Once we accept a student and admit the student onto campus, we as a university or community should treat all students equally. So we cannot say that you are non-local student, you cannot go to the library, for example. So this is the increasing the tuition fee will help collectively to provide better resources for the entire university. With that point, I look around all the counselors, and I assume that all of you are local youngsters. How come we have 20% of non-local students on campus, and they are not part of this particular body? So I think us students in Hong Kong, or students in Hong Kong, we should try very hard to engage these very good students. These are the best and the brightest students from around the world, to engage and contribute to the community. And I hope that maybe in the future years, when I look around this body again, I would be able to see some non-local students actively participating. And if they do, and if we welcome them, this will not be an issue anymore.
Thank you very much. Mr.
Herwin. Yeah, I agree with the DVC that we are here not to participate in the debate, but to provide information. I have a few clarifications to make. about this 15%, 50%, it is not a regulation, it's not a policy, it's an aim that we try to gain 50%, 50% mission. When we admit students from places outside the mainland, from local students, we actually consider a few issues. Number one is that we do not want to admit students from one particular, a large number of students from one particular country. And secondly, that we have to maintain the quality, so this is very important. About the postgraduate students, especially the research students, what I've heard from supervisors, from teachers, that our local students are not willing to continue their studies, to do research, to do MPhD and PhD. So I feel our teaching colleagues will be very happy if more Hong Kong students, when they finish their undergraduate students' studies, they are willing to apply for further studies as to do MPhil or PhD. And about the fee, I've seen in your booklet, you talk about the average fee of 233,000 in a course per student. But we have to bear in mind that this is a very rough number. And also for students studying in different disciplines, I mean, the course will be different. And non-local students, the majority of them are doing programs in business, in social sciences, and so on. So I think that this single thing of 233,000 could be misleading. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So, Dr. Abachar.
Chairman and councillors, well, once again, thank you for giving us this opportunity to provide some information on this particular issue. There are two issues that I would like to speak on, because one councillor has mentioned four places, okay, which is under my portfolio. At the moment, we assigned roughly around 1,900 four places or residential places to non-local students. You know, one third of the places in undergraduate halls are designated for non-local students, and about two thirds in the residential colleges are designated to non-local students. That's about 1,900. Altogether, it is about 30% of our places for undergraduate students. But these places also include the places we assign to exchange students who are here for 1 year or one semester. And that number is around 1,000, definitely. So you can see that the non-local student places are not that lopsided. Besides, the non-local students would get a need score of 100. Okay, so do local students. You have to spend more than 3 hours per day on transportation, on commuting to the university and back home. And all these need-based students will get 1 year, 1 year of hall place, either in the halls or the residential colleges. So we are not saying that our local students will be given, say, guarantee for, say, 3 year or 4 year residential place, but instead, alongside with the local students who have absolute needs, they get 1 year, and then the rest of the year, for the rest of their study period, they will be competing on equal basis. So I would like to clarify that point. The second point is about employment. I got some data with me, but most of the data are from our mainland graduates, because we don't have a lot of overseas graduates in the past few years. Now, roughly, 60% of these graduates, undergraduates, got employment after their graduation. And then among these 60% who work after their graduation, around 90% of them stay in Hong Kong. All right, now, so it depends on how you look at it. We talked about the shortage of talents in Hong Kong. A few days ago, I also heard a news report saying that a few years from now, Hong Kong will be short of people who have tertiary education background. Now, so if you look at it from that side of the equation, these people, these graduates are indeed helping the economy or helping the future development of Hong Kong. But if you look at it from the competition side, all right, then you may say that, well, they are competing with local students for jobs. But I guess in this world, it is really hard to bring fans certain resources or certain jobs for a particular group of people. With globalization, with the high mobility of capital, human talents, but you can see that no matter where you are from, local or non-local, mainland or overseas, you will be facing competition from all over the world. So these are the information that I would like to put forward for your consideration. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And from now on, there will be a discussion for our union full member and our councillors. And for union full member who are newly joined our annual debate, you can get the annual debate booklet at the side of the venue. It will be a booklet consists of the written opinion by the councillors. And from now on, there will be a discussion between union full member and councillors. So in this section, until the end of this agenda, I would like to grant the speaking rights to all union full members. Is there any objections? If no speaking, I grant. Union full member who would like to express their view towards the issue can raise up your hands. And we will have wireless mic around this venue to let you to speak. And any union full member would like to express their opinion, or any councillors want to continue their opinion first? Current Affairs Secretary Yip Kwan Kee.
其實今日呢年年排點解會發生？其實好多時候因為本地嘅學生競爭已經係好激烈。其實睇翻我哋本身香港年排，香港雖然成日都係以國際都會自豪，但係根本上我哋嘅大學入學率係比起美國、歐美嗰個甚至乎中國大陸都還低嘅。咁點解會有逆變而產生？但係呢條逆變又並唔足以解決目前而家本地學生面對嘅困境。其實針對今日面對嘅困境，應該係由兩個層面去睇，分別係政府嘅層面同學校層面。
但學校嚟講，好應該去考慮一下內地生同埋非同海外生之間嘅比例，亦都好希望學校能夠真正達到50:25嗰個比例。因為其實睇翻以往嘅錄取，內地生嘅數目一直都係多於海外生嘅。咁另外從政府嘅層面嚟講，好應該係珍惜下學生所提出嘅税金，好應該係付出更多嘅資源去俾我哋本地嘅學生，亦都係應該減少多啲嘅政府資助嘅海外生。 嚟將呢資源抽到學校本身，應該更加重要嘅係，因為而家香港情況就係讀唔到大學，等於係等於係一個競爭力極低嘅狀況。所以其實今次就算我哋讀副學士學位，亦都係好希望借呢啲途徑將我上博士學位，都更加希望做嘅係確保翻私立院校嘅教學質素同埋競爭資格嘅優秀性。咁私立人有令到即使人唔到大學，仍然能夠保障到佢嘅競爭力。咁先係雙方齊下嚟解決到大學學位增加大學位，同埋保障到非人唔到大學嘅競爭力。
咁好，即係我哋討論嘅問題就好應該係諗清楚。我覺得咁嘅motion做得更加好咯。所以其實應該跟政府係應該去了解翻非本地生人，而大學係應該考慮清楚校生同埋海外生之間嘅比例，更加方便。I would like to clarify that the motion topic is decided in the 7th ordinary council meeting when all councillors vote for the motion to be discussed today. And I need to explain to our union full member about this. And to generalize what have been discussed, we can see that there are actually four issues raised by this topic. First, the mainland students, the ratio of mainland students in the universities, the government resources provided to local students, and the university resources provided to local and non-local students, and the cultural and the intellectual exchange between local and non-local students. And what's more is that the employment rate of the graduates or whether the students of the non-local students who stay in Hong Kong is also another issue that we need to discuss. Maybe we can divide our discussion like this. Maybe we first discuss about the mainland students' ratio. Shall we? Councillors and union full members who would like to express their opinion on the ratio of the mainland student admitted to the university, can express your views now. Mr. Lan.
Hello. How's it? Regarding my local student. So you guys have been saying that Hong Kong is not internationalized enough and we should lower the mainland quota. What you guys say is the predisposition that mainland students is bad, but why is that so? I mean, isn't that kind of like discriminating and kind of racist to an extent? Like, the feeling I'm getting from the whole council is the fact that you guys have been saying mainland students, we want more international people, but not mainland. But the fact is we have so much more to learn from our mainland counterparts. Generally, for them to get into Hong Kong, they have a much harder corridor to get into. Like, they're literally the top in Gaokao in China for them to get into Hong Kong. They're hardworking and dedicated. And some people say they come to Hong Kong because it's their first choice. But that's not true for many of the mainland students. They have the academic standing to get into Ivy League. It's just the fact that due to financial restraint, they choose Hong Kong instead. So I don't get why everyone's saying that we want more international people and not mainland. There's so much more we can learn from the mainland people. And the hump I'm getting is, why are we discriminating and singling out the mainland student as opposed to treating him as a non-local participant as a whole? Thank you.
Thank you very much. And also would like to raise out that actually from the opinion from some councillors, they would like to take the ability as the requirement to enter the university, because some of them think that actually whether you are a mainlander or you are students from the other country is not the matter, but the ability of the student does. So I would like to also clarify this point to other union full members who joined our discussion lately. And would any other councillors or union full members would like to express their opinion on this issue? President.
主席，其實我就住即係非本地生入面嘅收生比例。
The best one, Stanford, Harvard, Berkeley. If they want to admit the best student, they can have the entire class top student, straight A students, which they're not doing. They want a diverse environment for the student. They want the student body to represent the society that you walk into. You have rich student, poor student, academic excellent student, academically not so excellent students, sporty students, student who can sing and dance, student who can perform, etc., etc. So for university, we have to drive for that balance. It will be very easy for the university just pick the best top A students. Our job will be done, and then the entire body will be very homogeneous. So that's explain the reason behind it. Will there be a formula driven? No, there's no formula driven. We all depends on our good colleagues in the registry office to use their 10, 20, 30 years of experience to pick the best student out of a country, out of a region, to fit into our university so that student could provide additional value add to the environment that you guys are learning from. So the target of 50-50 is just an arbitrary, without any scientific proof of whether 50-50 is better than 60-40, we basically, this is something Hong Kong as a society is new to Hong Kong. We just opened up to take non-local students just about 10 years ago. It used to be only 1%, 2%. Without any more experience, we say that, okay, let's do 50-50 or 60-40. It depends on the source of the students and the amount of effort we go out. And this number could be adjusted according to what kind of environment we want to provide for all the students on campus.
我都即對於呢個變後，我都好想講就係話，我哋咁多個參數啊，唔係話覺得內地生嘅同學唔好或者點嘅，我哋就住呢一個比例嘅問題上，我哋可以自己翻到數據，就係話2013至2014年度啦，內地生佢apply入康區要係12,803個，而我哋選取嘅學生係321,900個，咁我都相信其實我哋對於內地生嘅收生精英計嚟講係即係一路都實，咁我都好相信入咁多位明年嘅學生都係以佢哋好優秀嘅才能先入到康區，我覺得我哋唔應該亂嘅。
但我哋即係希望嘅就係話，我都相信在地生嘅同學嚟到 Hong Kong 都係希望接觸到更加多唔同文化背景學生啲 overseas student。咁對於我哋而家 overseas student 佢哋 apply 入學嘅人數都係即只係3261個啦，據數據統計嚟講。咁係遠遠低過內地學生，即係話我哋對於佢哋吸引力係唔夠高，所以我覺得我哋聚焦喺呢個問題上，應該係我哋如何去提升翻香港喺國際即作為一個國際學府上面嘅形象，然後吸引更加多 overseas 嘅學生，先可以加強到我哋對於唔同文化嘅交流呢一個宗旨。
Mr. Lam, please.
I got a question to the President. Why do you think there's only 3,161 international students applying to Hong Kong U? What do you think makes Hong Kong U not so attractive to the international students?
Thank you, Chairman. And I think that there are several reasons. The first one is Hong Kong, the tuition fee is not that cheap compared with other countries in Asian region. And also the location is quite far away. Yeah. And
please.
Echoing that student's question just now with regards to data, apart from data, President, would you acknowledge the fact that as a student body, you're not reaching out to mainland students and to non-local students? As a president of the student union, what do you think is the right way, to reach out to all the students?
Yes, I know that as a local student, I face some difficulty and challenges to reach out and communicate with non-local students. And basically, I think that the first barrier is the language problem. What I think that we can reach out to non-local students to use more English and bilingual language to communicate, or for different publication to show and explain what we are doing now. And the second one is, the attitudes of local students or their daily activities, they probably will willing to play with or like study with their own circle, local students, rather than communicate with non-local students. And in fact, for the student union as a president, at first, when I'm looking for my members of the executive committee, I'm I would like to find some non-local students to run for the election with me, but at last they cannot keep up and they quit the executive committee, and I feel sorry about that. I just think that as a president, I just want to find out more opinion leaders from the non-local groups to join in the student union and represent the non-locals, and at least we and the local students can hear what your opinion is. Yes, thank you.
Do there are any comments to the president's answers? There are no comments, right? Is it comment or questions? Comment. I will let those who didn't speak to answer to speak first. Okay. Ms. Park, please.
Okay. Hi, hello. My last name is Park, and it's just that it seems like there is a contradiction in the debate right now. First of all, you guys mentioned that we should change the percentage of non-local intake, and then you moved on to the changing of percentage intake of local students. And then you guys mentioned later on that the admission system is it should be based on the capabilities of the students, which then will contradict that, contradict the system of percentages. You have to understand, like, I understand that you guys want the equal balance between locals and non-locals, and I also understand that there should be, like, you guys want good quality students. Then, like, you shouldn't just, then it seems a bit contradicting that you should decrease non-local students and increase the number of local students intake, because if it was purely based on the capabilities, then this percentage should not even exist. However, from looking at the school point of view, it is just a guide, as the professor said, it is as a guide to have a percentage system so that we get a more mixture. It's easier for the school to have that system. So that's why they have the percentage system. So all I'm saying is that, like, right now, like, I'm confused because first you guys are saying the percentage should be set, and then second you guys are saying there, like, no, it should be based on the capabilities. But from my point of view, it's good to have the percentage system just so that we have more mixture. And I'm not saying I do not have any hard feelings to, like, mainlanders or anything, but if the international student percentage, if it's concentrated in one country, then of course it's not really international. So that question can be also raised. But then now you guys are debating on, like, the quality of HKU, which is astray from the debate topic. And I don't know, like, I don't know why this debate topic is first raised. Like, if you want to talk about the percentage of local student intake, then have that as a topic, not this. If you want to talk about the percentage of mainlanders between internationals, then have that as a topic. Why should the debate topic be such a negative that it should be the maximum intake of non-local applicants to HKU holders be reduced? I'm just saying, the debate topic and the debate seems to be very wide and confusing.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. 或者我用中文解釋先啦。其實點解我哋本身要設定立呢一個 motion 咧？其實呢一議題咧係只係一個切合點俾我哋去再去有一啲討論嘅，因為本身喺我哋嘅評議會嘅會議裡面咧，我哋就係見到嘅係有啲咩問題。第一就係好似明明香港大學就係為一間國際嘅大學，咁但係點解喺裏面收生裏面好似嗰個平衡裏面係有問題咧？第二， 既然國際化係要去令到我哋嘅學生嘅quality係更加好嘅話，咁點解我哋好似未見到嗰個效果喺出面呢？咁所以我哋就諗啦，究竟會唔會係本身喺收生方面係有問題？咁然後我哋就希望利用呢一條議題嘅答案嚟講出，究竟我哋要去探討，究竟係咪香港大學嘅收生，無論係比例啊，即就住針對住係國際 化嘅呢個比例裏面，係咪會係有一啲嘅問題係應該我哋要去呢一刻度向大學或者同各位同學去討論去 raise out 咧？咁所以我哋先會用呢一條嘅議題嚟嘅啫。咁同大家講翻咧，議案咧係有一個有立場嘅一個 statement 嚟嘅。咁但係
That's why we should raise our fee to attract more people. So therefore, capitalists actually ask the question again. And secondly, as a, regarding not recruiting international people in the second committee, have you ever thought about why they don't join? Maybe it's the fact that it's because full Cantonese. How can a person who does not speak Cantonese join the second committee and go through a ridiculously long hours of campaign? Thank you, President.
President.
Thank you, Chairman. And I want to clarify and answer again your question. I think that the reason behind why overseas non-JUPAS students only got 3,000 is that Hong Kong is not that famous or best in around the world compared with other universities in UK or the United States. And about your accusation about that the candidates within the executive committee member, because like I run for the election this year, I'm not control the campaign stuff or the executive committee members, like the language used within our committee. At the very beginning, I recruit and I find some non-local students to join us and we just have our discussion in English. And we have our campaign. Some students choose to use Chinese to ask us questions, but some choose English and we try to translate this question from the students and tell the non-local students of our executive committees. But we just try to like integrate them into our student union, but most of the non-local students working in the student bodies, they just feel comfortable and express freely in Cantonese. I admit that we still have a long way to go, but yes, I can see that the because I'm a year four student now, compared with 3 years ago, there are more non-local students going into the student bodies in Hong Kong U, both mainland students and overseas students. And yes, we work hard on this, and I admit that currently the situation is not satisfactory. Yeah, thank you.
I just want to remind every union for member and every councillor that since time is really short, and then we need to have more students who speak and to express their opinion. I would coordinate, but I will offer the opportunities to those who didn't speak before, and no matter as union for member or councillors. Mr. Lam, is it your comment or follow up, right? Okay, Mr. Lam, please.
Thank you. So you answered with that because we're infamous. So that's not what I answered. Can you please answer it again? You still haven't answered my question. Why we're not attracting globalized students in Hong Kong? And secondly, I want to ask that you were saying yes, there's room to improve internationalization between local and non-local students in Hong Kong. So can you promise us something? What would you do in the next year that can help better integrate the local and the non-local students? And the fact that many societies in Hong Kong is only conducted in Cantonese. How do you expect us to join in? There's like the national society now. The fact that the SOS is very ironic because that's the only society in Hong Kong that's actually run fully in English. The rest of the German society by HKUSU is run in Cantonese. So do you promise us something? Make some promise here in front of everyone. What you will do this year to make sure that local and non-local can better integrate. Thank you, President.
Sorry, I need to clarify that most of the student organization affiliated to the HKUSU have both Chinese and English as their official language. So I need to remind you about that, to clarify about that. And then, I want to answer questions. I will lend the opportunities to those who didn't speak first. Okay. Social Secretary, Jack Ayer.
Thank you, Chairman. So I think regarding the question about why we're not so attractive towards like international students, it's really not our like question to answer, because I think I really don't know like, what people far away in like the States and UK think about HKU. But I think when they choose like a university like myself, I would think about distance and also the cost. So the tuition fee of Hong Kong might not be like that high, but you have to take into consideration like the airfare for them to come over, the accommodation and everything else. So maybe for some international students from like the States or UK, the distance coming over here to Hong Kong is too much for them, and they would want to study like somewhere closer to their own family. So during weekends or anything, they could actually afford to go home and see like their friends and family. So this might be one of the reasons like why HKU is not that attractive to like most international kids. But we really don't know because most of us are actually from the Asia region, as you can tell. So it's really not our question to answer. Thank you.
Administrative Secretary Lo John.
好似今日咁樣，無論中文、無論英文，大家都係互相尊重，講翻自己語言，令到大家明白講緊啲咩。咁先係一個真正國際化啊嘛，融合呢個字，公民真係代表國際化，因為融合係代表我哋要逼埋一邊、埋一樣去遷就嚟一邊。但係真正國際化一個平台，一個公平嘅機會，等大家互相認識，就好似我哋香港大學生會，英文、中文都係官方語言，大家只要識得講嘅，我哋都會盡量去translate或者等大家真真正正去了解大家互相尊重呢一個先係真真正正我哋希望可以達到國際化，而唔係話一邊希望逼大家要我哋理解就要講英文，定係講中文咁樣，定係一個互相平衡。
因為咧見到而家咧嗰個問題嘅重點咧就究竟香港大學係唔係國際化呢個問題去做呢一個討論嘅。咁但係我都想去提清釐清一點，就係我哋今日嘅議案咧，其實係講緊究竟非本地收生嘅限額係唔係應該要調低嘅。咁所以我覺得即係就住翻究竟。 大學係唔係國際化呢一個問題，可唔可以嚟最嬲尾嘅一次嘅記名嘅討論？如果係有基本會員或者有評議員想就住香港大學國際化呢個問題，仲有一啲嘅意見嘅話，希望你哋而家舉手，我會記低你哋個名，之後就冇再其有其他嘅同學或者評議員可以再就住呢個問題去做討論㗎啦。有邊位同學或者評議員想就住呢個問題有最後嘅一輪發言？
而教生M表係有3,783%，31.6%。教學即係自資課程咧，有錢就可以報讀嘅自資課程，佢有8,034個人，68.2%。而non-local咧係佔咗42%，local係佔咗52%。
而喺羅州嗰5,690個報讀自資課程嘅非本地生裏面咧，英聯係有72%，非英聯嘅非本地生咧有28%。其實我唔明點解呢個數目係會可以膨脹得咁犀利或者咁緊要。其實呢個數目或者呢個比例嘅內地生係咪先至會令到同學官覺得香港大學正喺度內地化緊咧？呢個係咪先係問題核心所在呢？即其實即有因為有校方代表喺度咧，或者政府可以解答下，即點解港大係需要咁多嘅自資課程，而呢啲自資課程吸引嘅內地生同埋吸引嘅非本地生又大多係以內地生居首咧？咁大學喺啲課程裏面設立嘅目的係乜嘢？係唔係同大學教理念違背呢？因為大學教理念本身就係想追求真理，或者追求學識，或者追求研究嘛。但係呢啲自資課程而家坊間或者社會都批評過，係咪大學就係期望因為大學支出太龐大啦，所以係需要用呢啲自資課程嘅收入去擔夠、去補充大學喺其他資源調配上面嘅不足，所以要咁大量嘅自資課程衍生出嚟去做呢啲問題咧？咁但係如果呢個係一個原因嘅話，係咪扭曲大學教育本身嘅價值咧？即係為咗啲商業理由或者生存理由而被迫去行使或者設立一啲唔係以教理念為目的嘅一啲課程？呢、這個目的其實我唔知大學校方而家係點樣諗嘅，但係咧，如果個問題確實喺度嘅，咁其實需要處理嘅喎。呢個係咪牽涉到其實大學校方同教資會嘅關係？係咪覺得教資會控制喺大學校方太緊要，繼而大學係需要有透過啲自資課程去令到自己有更多嘅財政能力去行使佢自己嘅自主權咧？教資會1980年嗰陣，香港係跟英國嗰套設立咗教資會，但係而家英國已經取消咗啦，香港仲有教資會，而且既然如果教資會係一個問題嘅話，大學校方係唔係需要去同其他大學嘅高層一齊商量或者處理教資會仲有冇需要成立或者設立喺香港呢個地方？即係我諗，非本地生限額喺 postgraduate 嗰邊其實需要設立限額，或者就要特別係自資課程嘅。係唔可以再收咁多非本地生，因為佢一來佢大學嗰個課程設計就係有違大學理念，而佢而家呢個咁樣課程設計同埋咁樣去吸引啲非本地生去參加嘅時候，好大程度其實好似呃緊啲非本地生嚟香港去讀呢啲課程嘅，即係我唔知道大學校方會唔會有回應啦，但係覺得呢個問題如果存在嘅話，亦都係構成香港大學生對於香港大學正喺度國際化緊，繼而引申出。香港大學係應該整體調低非本地生限額嘅話，大學校方係需要就呢方面作出啲 clarification 去解決成個問題。
So the next one will be President of the Independent Clubs Association. Okay. So now will be Mr. Chu.
Okay, my name is Joe. First of all, thank you very much for organizing this debate and listening to students' worries and concerns. I just have like a more general comment to make. I think this topic of this debate boils down to a much more fundamental question. I think the fundamental question Hong Kong wants to ask itself is whether Hong Kong U wants to be a globally connected and globally respected university or simply a local Chinese university of local standing.And I think if Hong Kong U wants to be a globally respected and globally connected university, Hong Kong U really has to fully embrace internationalism. And whether an applicant is local or non-local really shouldn't be an issue. All that should count is academic merit and leadership potential. And if you look at some of the leading universities in the United Kingdom or the US, that's exactly the policies they have in place. For example, I did my first degree in the United Kingdom.And I remember when I looked at the student bodies at LSE, KCL, or UCL, in some of the most sort of competitive courses like economics or law, maybe up to two-thirds of the undergraduate students on these courses were not originally from the UK. The last proportion actually was from Singapore and Hong Kong. And I think that's perfectly fine because they really went according to academic merit and they really just wanted to attract the best and brightest, and that's why I think these institutions are doing so well. And I think if Hong Kong U wants to get into this league, it also has to embrace internationalism to the same extent. Thank you.
Thank you very much. very much. So now we'll be Mr. Ken, please.
Thank you very much for the talking. I'm from Korea and I'm here two students. And I have a lot of local friends, I do indeed. But I come to Hong Kong here because the language used in lecture and the mode of language is English. So we internationally agree that we use English to communicate with people from different countries. So Hong Kong here is indeed an international university, I think. But so the lecturer, so the professors speak English, although they will feel comfortable speaking their own mother tongue, right? Because they care about the international students. If they speak Chinese to me in the lecture, I wouldn't be able to understand. So there's no reason going to lecture, I'll just read a book. But I do want to, we international students do want to join the international school activities like drama or choreographer, photography club, but there are a lot of local students who will be comfortable to speak Cantonese. And it's hard to speak English between the locals, I do agree. That's why I feel when I was with my Korean friends. But then, it's a different sense. If you are in the activity, it's an official club, you have a responsibility to care about other members. But if you guys just feel comfortable in speaking Cantonese, then other international students will feel odd and don't have a sense of belonging in the club. So I think Hong Kong local students who organize the mostly organized by the activities are mostly organized by locals because there are more local students than international students in Hong Kong. So I'd like to if the local students have more care for the international students and then speak English in all the activities. So, because if you guys speak English in your activity, you will improve English as well as have a more international friends, which will help you have a global perspective. It will help you in the future job because you will be working with a lot of international colleagues. Yeah. So. Yeah, so that was my comment on how just I want locals. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Ken, for your opinion, because I think that it's a very suitable occasion for you to have advice on this student organization, because in our council, we are the representative of different student organizations, like halls, faculties, clubs, etc. So your opinion will directly be heard by these counselors, and I think that they would do something to improve the situation. Thank you very much. So the next one will be representative of Lee Chi Hong for Student Association, Chan Jun Ho.
Chief, 咁多同學講咗你國際嗰個競爭力幾低啦，咁其實咧問學校有咩方法提高翻我哋嘅國際排名？因為其實都已經佈置咗個燈，我哋跌咗嘅，咁我想問學校學校有啲咩會做，咁樣去提升翻？
For those who are marked down your name, do you have any other questions that you want to raise to the representative of the university? Because I can gather all these questions and let the representative of the university to answer. Okay, Professor Valenci.
What are the questions?
What is the
ranking?
What method the school may adopt to increase our international ranking?
The best method is to train leaders and have leaders to have global outlook, fair, open, non-discriminatory. And as a university, we don't care much about ranking. We care about education and grading and knowledge. The ranking is only the public that want to know. So we were not driven by ranking. If you run a university by ranking, you should not be coming to Hong Kong U. You will be disappointed. So we don't run a university by ranking. We run a university by training the best and the brightest and to create knowledge. So my answer may disappoint you, but this is a true answer, the attitude of the university.
And so, now the next one will be Student Senator 1, Lee Kai-dek.
Thank you, Chair. I'd like to take the chance to respond to a lot of questions raised by our fellow union food members. There is a very strange point about Singapore and Hong Kong is that all of us know English and have certain English proficiency. Almost none of us speak English as our first language. So for all internationals coming to Hong Kong, there should be a disappointment about you have considered, oh, I know English well, so I would be able to communicate with all Hong Kong people. But the fact it is, in all daily occasions, we normally speak our mother tongue, but that's very natural. And perhaps this is a very, perhaps this is a deeper issue for both Singapore and Hong Kong have to consider. Whether we should embrace more international, more international element or to consolidate our local identity. Regarding for international students to join student clubs and student bodies, I have to say, in all countries, there will be a difference between the host and guests. Somehow it's really hard for our international to assimilate themselves into the local community. So what you can do is to learn more Hong Kong culture and try your best to acquire Cantonese. It is not our fault for not speaking English in our daily living. It's our right to speak Cantonese at all times. So please Hong Kong, so we are Hong Kongers. Cantonese is our language we speak. So we, in case we have to face international, we can switch. But most of the time, we have to uphold our mother tongue. Thank you.
I'm so sorry because you did some marked speech for your counselors. 因為咧呢個係一個即係因為已經係去到記名發言嘅環節㗎啦，咁所以只有係頭先記咗名嘅同學或者評語先可以咧喺呢一個環節嗰度發言。咁同埋咧，主席都要提醒一下，因為我哋時間真係唔夠，咁所以如果每一位同學真係要發言嘅時候咧，請你盡量精簡，唔該曬。
The next one will be Mr. Lam, Mr. Lam, Mr. Okay, Mr. Sorry.
My name is Ivan. Yeah, I just want to emphasize that Hong Kong U is aiming to become an international institution. So, to reach that level, as the gentleman there has said, that we all have to embrace that speaking English in this university, at least in the university. So there's no debate whether you should accept non-local or local. Like, when you have the capability, you have the English proficiency, you can be admitted to the Hong Kong U, regardless of your nationality, regardless of your race. So, and continuing from that, when the Hong Kong U Student Union, they say they care about the student body, they should care about the both local and non-local. And when you speak Cantonese, you are only defending the rights of the local students because they are more comfortable speaking Cantonese. But in fact, the whole of student body, everyone can speak English, but all the non-local students can't speak Cantonese. And when we come to Hong Kong U, we don't expect to speak Cantonese. When Hong Kong is marketed to all the countries, it's marketed as an international university. So when we come here, we only expect that, oh, we can speak English, so we are safe. Not like, let's say we want to go to Peking University, we need to speak Mandarin. Everyone knows that you need to speak Mandarin if you want to go to Peking University. And let's say I'm in European country. You need to speak German, you need to speak Spanish to go to the university. But to Hong Kong U, we know that we only need to speak English, so we come here. And I was so shocked when I come here. Like, everyone speaks Cantonese. Like, although I accept that right now, but the fact that I need to adapt and not what I have expected that to speak Cantonese in this university is not acceptable. So when the student union wants to care about the student body, at least the rule has to be set that everyone has to speak English
Because, yeah, definitely it's not your first language. It's not my first language. It is not everyone's first language. So it can be a medium of integration. Let's say in Singapore, a lot of non-locals, a lot of locals, and the locals speak Chinese. They speak Chinese to each other. Let's say I'm Indonesian, we speak Indonesian to our people. So, but when we want to speak to Singaporeans, or we want to speak to Hong Kong people, we want to speak to Chinese, mainland Chinese, we all speak English. So in Singapore, in the Asian University of Singapore, the student body is more integrated because everyone speaks English. Even the student union, even the hall societies, everyone participates in the hall activities. Like, they have similar hall activities in Singapore. Everyone speaks English. So that's where all the integration will be like fulfilled. So when there's no rule that everyone must speak English, there won't be integration in this university. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So the next one will be Mr. please.
Gentlemen over there, the blue shirt. The reason why I bring up this internationalization of Hong Kong is so much the fact that by lowering international applicants to Hong Kong U, you're going to make Hong Kong U less internationalized. This will in turn attract less students from the international body. That will make Hong Kong U even less internationalized. Given the fact that President agreed on the fact that internationalization of Hong Kong is very important, why would you want to lower the intake of non-local applicants? Shouldn't the opposite happen, given how globalized the world is? We employers are looking for students that are very internationalized. Yes, we are on the point that, yes, we need to learn to make it. I can speak English, speak on Hong Kong. But the fact is that, why shouldn't you accommodate the international language as opposed to forcing us to all learn Hong Kong? Therefore, this is the reason I find it illogical to reduce the intake of the local students, given how internationalized Hong Kong already is. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Sala, for your opinion. So the next one will be Ms. Kim. Ms. Kim, please.
My name is thank you so much for having this opportunity to have a conversation. And well, apart from the society thing, like raising families, like I will talk more about the international stuff. Well, actually, I understand that international ranking is not the effective way of evaluating value, and I'd like to value at the university in like even for this core purpose of like to educate people. And I think the university education doesn't only include the academic one, but also including the humanities point. To be actually the citizen of the global world, and in that aspect, I'm especially thinking that Hong Kong U is considered as the international university, not just the just one university and like localized university in Hong Kong. I think that I value that those rankings actually suggested the internationality of Hong Kong U is really critical point we have to consider in this issue. And I think that no local applicants, no local products cannot guarantee the internationality of the school to some point. So I think reducing the intake, but not the intake of non-local applicants, is actually harming the internationality of the school. And even also their international rankings, they will believe that their rankings are not all the things that they have to consider. But still, I think that that's one way to evaluate how the university is going.
Okay, thank you very much. And then, the next one will be represented from Social Science Society, Mr. Ken.
Mr. Sam Kan Hong.
Thanks, Chairman. To wrap up what we have just been discussing, I will have some points to respond. The first point is I would like to show my view towards the word discrimination, because some of you have mentioned it. What do I perceive about discrimination? It is when the equal opportunities are not given to anyone to access to the system or to join different organizations in different occasions. However, what am I facing in Hong Kong U is not about the equal opportunities. We have equal opportunities for everyone to join those organizations. We have constitutions, we have language supports, we have translation. It is about how or the freedom of us to choose what language we use. Just like there is an international student who would like to join the executive committee of my society next year. We also provide her with language support and we translate her our constitution or our some regulations in English. However, it is up to everyone's choice that whether they could use Chinese or English. We cannot force them to use English as a rule because I think the language to use, I mean the freedom to use what language is as of right. The second response to the question or the motion is that I think the establishment of a quota is to balance the interests of both local students and non-local students. I don't really agree that we should all intake all students based on the capability of different students and the most bright, the brightest or the most talented students should be admitted because based on what is happening in Hong Kong, there are really many, there are many from students who cannot be admitted to Hong Kong universities. So we have to base on this reality and we have to set this quota. And the last point I would like to raise is that I very agree about deputy from the university body have suggested that once the non-local students have been admitted to Hong Kong U, we should not have a difference. We should not regard them as different in Hong Kong. In Hong Kong U, they are the same with us. They should not be regarded differently. However, I would like to suggest that it is all up to our students. It is all up to us to choose whether we should use Cantonese or use English. We should not have any enforcement or we should not have any regulations to regulate on the language we should use. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And the last one will be Mr. Chow. Mr. Chow.
This question shouldn't even be put up at this moment. We, as a student body, can't even integrate fully the 20% of people that are in the
room.
How are we, let's say, even we do raise this up to 30% and we get 10% more international students, we still have that we are local, they are international. There will just be another 10% more people here, 10% more people. 10% more people. Oh, yeah, different. I'm just thinking that if we want to integrate completely, we need to drop we are local, they are international. Because I'm going to say, I studied here, and I studied in Japan, and a lot of people here, I'm pretty sure, have been to other countries, even though they don't know what they want. Each time they go to those countries, they bring back something from those countries, something international. We are international. To the internationals who come here, we locals are international. So we have to get, we have to start thinking like we are one body. We're not a separate, like, we're not two separate sides. For that.
Thank you. So I think I need to conclude the above discussion in the 2 points. Because actually for our motion is investigating the mechanism for the intake of non-local students in HKU. And I think we need to make a decision on it. And the other one is based on our discussion between members, councillors, and we can see that from the written opinion of councillors. Actually, no matter you agree or you disagree with the motion. Actually, we have the same thoughts that we need to make our HKU an international university. So maybe we can also have our decision made on whether we will urge the university or the student organization to cater the international students' needs. And I think I need to quote a very good criteria from Professor Balanchine that international means fair, open, non-discriminating. And I think it's a very good requirement that we need to take into account. So in the following, I would like to ask if there are any councillors or union full members who want to make their final opinion on today's issues. You need to raise your hand because I need to mark down your names, and if not, there will be no speaking right around to anyone. Okay, let me wait a minute. CP, AR, ASR, LAR, MSR, RCLHR, in any okay, PC, PC4 also. And Sun Yat-sen Place, and any other students or union members who want to express their opinions on this issue. If no, okay, then I will start from the very beginning. President of the Cultural Association, Keeping. Anyone give him the ballot microphone?
多謝主席，剛才其實我見頭先都有好多副member都有講翻屬會嗰度，好似有好多時都忽略咗non-local student啦，咁其實我都想代表佢哋回應翻嘅，就係因為其實普遍我哋屬會一向都會係welcome所有嘅non-local students去參與佢哋嘅活動。 包括佢哋所有嘅 publication 其實都係會中英對接，而且佢哋每一個活動一旦抽到 student，佢哋都唔會 reject 嘅，而且喺活動安排上，其實佢哋都會喺特登分組上面會安排一班人去做翻一個英文嘅傳譯俾佢哋，所以我都希望。 non-local student可以明白翻呢一點。另外一個回應就係其實佢哋搞嘅 club 搞嘅活動好多時都需要去挑談，而挑談上面好難可以揾到英文嘅，因為始終佢哋都係揾翻香港嘅挑談，而好少挑談係會肯用英文去做呢一個教授，所以就會變相。 對non-local student可能會有翻少少嘅難度去參與到，而就算今日嘅議題其實我係 against 呢一個調低限額嘅，因為其實就住而家嘅限額20% 其實根本就未用盡啦，而且基本上我哋可以睇翻世界一流頂尖嘅大學其實招收緊嘅non-local student 根本就係。 above16%， 甚至乎去到20% 以上都有嘅。咁其實我哋而家 community 嘅15.5%，基本上係面臨點樣同世界頂尖嘅大學睇齊。所以我覺得，如果我哋再去降低個 intake 嘅話，其實我哋只會令到 community 嘅國際化走翻一個回頭路。多謝主席。
各位好，仍然會堅持用中文嘅，咁我認為如果用英文嘅話，可能令大家反而就會我表達嘅意見有兩樣嘢，第一樣嘢係遺憾嘅，遺憾嘅係今日我哋 emotion 其實我哋實際上討論嘅唔多，除咗首輪發言我哋有表達過呢個 emotion 嘅意見之外，其實我哋今日嘅討論咧，係討論緊港大係咪國際化，港大嘅學生會唔會用最好嘅英文，今日嘅 emotion 係咁多評議員大家經過深思先去講出嚟。 但係我哋對呢條報信嘅討論咧，似乎咧就並不多，甚至亦都有好多同學失焦。但係第二樣嘢，開心嘅，開心嘅就係今日見到咗咁多個學生會嘅會員走過嚟去 comment
HKUSU 的 policy comment on 呢一條 motion。今日係一堂 education 嚟嘅，大家平時係冇一個咁嘅機會咧，去接受咁嘅教育，去了解乜係 Union Council meeting， 乜嘢 annual debate， 點解今日咁多同議員、咁多你哋所屬院會嘅代表坐咗喺度表達意見？點解學生會係淨係用中文唔用英文？點解學生會唔夠國際化？點解學生會 policy 唔夠 tailor to local students？ 今日呢一樣嘢好重要啊，俾大家知道曬。原來我哋學生會係點嘅？學生會點樣運作？學生會幹事會係點樣對於議題有咩意見嘅？我希望今日無論我哋對於 motion、應該 resolution 係點都好，大家都可以記住，如果我哋要向學生會表達意見，有好多渠道，唔係淨係嚟 annual debate， 唔係淨係嚟中山廣場表達意見，你哋可以去 email office， 你哋可以去學生會舉辦嘅論壇去表達嗰啲意見。如果因為今日關鍵嘅 issues， 咁大家就好似比較熱衷。呢、這個議題好似有興趣，但係平時對於學生會其他嘅事務唔關心。剛才講嘅學生嘅歸屬感嘅問題，我覺得學生嘅歸屬感嘅問題唔係我哋使用咩語言，而係我哋關唔關心學生會嗰啲究竟愛唔愛嘅學生。而如果你想認識呢個學生會，想關心學生會，想愛啲學生會，第一步你要了解佢先。你要了解到啲文字場入邊 force 嘅嘢，你要了解到 union office 係做乜嘢嘅。咁所以希望大家今日可以了解多啲學生會。關心嗰啲學生，唔好淨係今日呢個現象之後就算啦。
The next one will be the representative of Architectural Society, Mr. Wong Wei Lun.
Thank you, Chairman. I'm for this project. Actually, the previous question has raised an interesting one. That is that why we all the councilors sitting here is local student. And actually, I'm thinking that. According to the local policy, it is to promoting the cultural exchange. But when we are thinking about the current situation, is that really is that really enough just admitting more and more non-local students will solve this and will reach the aim of the non-local policy? And so, of course, we all see that it is not effective. And according to this motion, as we have just limited resources. And so that we should reduce the maximum meeting of the over applicants. We allocate the resource to other programs or to the cultural exchange rather than just admitting more local students or international students.
Thank you very much. And next comes to the representative of Law Association, Ms. Stage Yuwei, issue and please.
Thank you, Chairman. I would say I'm very happy to see many crew members expressing their views towards the international status of the Hong Kong group, so that for the maximum intake of the learning applicants of the Hong Kong University, we don't have shared in the discussion. And like what Council Chairman has mentioned, we should talk about a few things that we have just mentioned as the ratio of the mainland students, the government subsidy, the cultural intellectual exchange, and employment rate of the graduate students of the local students in Hong Kong. But then for the following few factors, we do not have the chance to discuss. And what I'm mainly concerned about this motion is about the government subsidy from the South. Because I agree that the international status of Hong Kong U should be increased and that should be promoted by Hong Kong U and also the SU and our fellow students sitting here. But then if you say we have to use more government subsidy and to use more resources of the Hong Kong people to increase these places for non-local students, I do not agree. Because in the situation of Hong Kong, we can see that we have less than 20% of students getting into university. Do not say the top university in Hong Kong, which is Hong Kong U, we are standing here right now. So I think it is also should be an aim of the students to for the student bodies and for the HKU to raise the number of local students to Hong Kong youth. Like we have all mentioned that 60% of non-local students should stay in Hong Kong after graduation. But then for the local students, even they are staying in Hong Kong for their life, they do not have a chance to get into university and receiving tertiary education in Hong Kong. For those students who have suggested that we should increase the private tertiary education and then for self-funded degrees outside this normal undergraduate places, I think this should be an opposite side. We should have both opportunities for our local students also for, and also for our local students. But then we shouldn't use this as a means to provide them with tertiary education. The root problem is that we should do it by ourselves and this Hong Kong view for it, most fundamental undergraduate degree. So thank you for listening and students.
Thank you very much. And I strongly advise all the counselors who will talk later to be present. Okay, now is the representative of Medical Society.
Thank you, Chairperson. First of all, it's really great to see the presentation of so many students in the new debate, and we'll have a teacher's discussion at least compared to last year's early debate. First of all, I would like to make some comments on the debate in the main debate. And my basic point of view is that we should raise the importance of local students and the just not many other students that have the mission score. And then why is it so? Because we actually really needed to consider the international orientation in Hong Kong youth. And then we should consider besides the academic capability of students, the cultural aspects. This is really important that because there are many objectives of the system to admit more local students is to bring cultural exchange and build reputation of Hong Kong youth internationally. And then if we have this pool of international students in our school, it's really beneficial to get the smart influence to go for international education. And then I would like to expand my opinion on the previous long discussions about the interaction between student societies and local students. I would think the main problem actually lies in the field impact of non-local students, because non-local students are now a minority in our society, which is Hong Kong youth. And then this is actually not a culture for our local students to speak English, because they are actually not used to speak English in some of the world, because majority of the students are local to speak Cantonese at the same time. And therefore, what we can see is that why foreign universities can have many people speaking English to their local students is that they have the culture of including the local students in their daily life. So I would like to say that it is really the right of every student to speak both Cantonese and English. And but the motive to speak English should be to involve local students in your activities and in your life. And so I would like to conclude by that because non-local students is actually a minority, and we do not have calculation as simple as like we have 1 in 6 non-local students and 6 students in Hong Kong, so we have 1 in 6 students in our student organizations or just union council. Because they are minority, they feel hard to know the local society. So the main topic lies in the impact of non-local students, because we need to create to achieve thanks, Chairperson.
Thank you very much. And the next will be the representative of RSL Horse Association, Mr. Lan Kai.
Hello. 對住呢條 motion 咧，其實我係反對嘅， 正如之前所講啦，咩為其實將啲資源投放喺我哋身嗰度，達至一個文化交流一個國際化嘅形象，其實係值得。咁但係我哋睇翻依家嘅情況，就係究竟喺唔同嘅各個團體，佢哋咪真係做到文化交流呢一樣嘢咧？作為一個社群嘅代表啦，其實回顧翻自己喺社團嘅情況，究竟有幾多嘅本地生係真正可以同？ 非本地生做咗一個文化嘅交流，而達至即係雙方都得到嘅利益，其實係相當之少。其實一個好 common 嘅情況就係本地生一般而言喺傳統嘅社團都係會同翻本地生相熟，其實係會溝得比較好，而從而唔覺意地排斥咗啲非本地生。呢個情況係特別嚴重，就係喺內地生嗰方面。 因為我哋身其實一般而言係好著重佢哋嘅成績啦，咁佢哋喺科活動嘅投入嘅程度其實都非常之少，咁相對於一啲非本地生一啲國外嘅學生，其實佢哋喺呢一方面嘅投入程度係比較少嘅時候，同本地生溝通都比較少，所以當我哋睇翻一個所謂嘅文化交流，其實喺社團入邊，本地生同一啲 國外嘅學生其實係會做得比內地生更加好，此其一。其二就係我覺得何方係需要正視嘅問題就係當我哋想達至文化交流，我哋有一啲唔同嘅方法，例如 buddy program 以至於各樣嘅方法去做到與本地生同非本地生相處嘅時候，究竟喺各個團體、同 society 啦、唔同嘅社團，我哋有冇做到呢一方面嘅功夫呢？其實係相對比較少。一般而言，我哋做咗啲調查，反映其實 非本地生對科嘅情況係相當之反感，因為佢哋可能投入邊度嘅活動啦。但係我哋需要正視嘅就係有啲乜嘢方法可以增加本地生嘅意欲，去同呢啲非本地生作出更多嘅交流。多謝主席。
Thank you very much. And now is the popularity at the Union Council of Five, Mr. Wong Wing Long Liu.
Thank you, Chairperson. And well, I'm really happy to have so many union co-members here today to join our debate. And my first point is that at the University of Hong Kong, and we are discussing the intake policy Hong Kong U, we should first consider the circumstances of Hong Kong, and this should be the most important circumstance. Background information that we should consider. And you can see that in Hong Kong, only 17% of secondary school graduates can get a subsidized undergraduate place. So unlike the situation in the United Kingdom or the USA, Hong Kong has a very low rate of subsidized undergraduate places for secondary school graduates. So we cannot compare, directly compare the case of UK and USA with Hong Kong. And given limited resources in higher education, we should very carefully consider what should be the advanced education policy of Hong Kong, as well as the main purpose of the education at Hong Kong U. In our opinion, there are three purposes. The first one is to raise the academic standards of local students. The second one is to realize the potential of cultural leaders in Hong Kong. And the third is create knowledge. So as a university of as a university at Hong Kong, we should not sacrifice the benefits of local students to exchange for the international status or the benefits of our local students. We should have a very good balance in the interests of the two groups. And so the second point is that Hong Kong U is both an international and local university. We have listened to the representative of the university management and they argue that globalization is a trend that we cannot stop, actually, the global students from getting jobs in Hong Kong. But the core question
that we should ask is that, should we prioritize the subsidy for local students instead of subsidizing the non-locals for the first degree program? Because in Hong Kong, only 70% can get the first degree subsidy. So should we have a better priority instead of giving the non-local students subsidy to this extent? And so I would like to restate here that our discussion topic is not about whether we should embrace international students or not. We welcome international students and we want more international students. But the circumstances of Hong Kong do not allow us to intake so many international students in this stage. So if we look at the statistics, when we consider both the undergraduate students and the postgraduate students, we have 33% of non-local students, and in which 66% come from mainland high school. So it seems a very good balance. So I consider that we have to reconsider the ratio. So at last, I would like to say that actually, we have many other ways to ensure the international cases and the interests of local students at the same time. For example, to increase the opportunities of exchange students. The exchange policy, the international exchange policy, is policy that is to provide local students with international horizons, and at the same time provide international students' opportunity to study at Hong Kong U. So this policy would not take up the interquota of Hong Kong U undergraduate. And at the same time, it can ensure the interests of both groups of students at the same time. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We still have two councillors who need to speak. And it is strongly advised that your speech shall be precise. Thank you very much. So the next one will be popularly the Union Councillor for Mr. So Chek Yu. Mr. So Chek, please.
Thank you, Chair President. 即係我話我發言咧，將會英文咧，因為大家都想今日參與討論嘅會眾都係幾點樣發言。So FMS stands for the current policy studies. However, we should consider the current situation of Hong Kong society that only 2% of the age group of 17 to 20 can enter the UCC from university. And also the next important point is that most of the students in Hong Kong consider or believe that having an undergraduate degree is their basic right, and this is also having an undergraduate degree is also very important and required in most of the jobs appear on the market. So I highly recommend the universities to consider the current admission policy. I do recommend that the maximum percentage of quota for international students should be unchanged at 10% as defined in policy which is implemented by the HKSAR government. However, the ratio of the local quotas for students from different countries or areas should be the equivalent or similar or the same. So that this won't create an illusion of the university only admit two kinds of students, like the two kinds like the students from Hong Kong, like the local and students from China. And the most important part is the remaining quotas for your local students from different countries should transfer to the category for local students, especially for local students. So that this could also solve the problem that family local students who are actually come from Jupas and most of the when Jupas applicants can't enter the university.
Thank you very much. And last one, Mr. Senator Wong, Mr. Dudley Kaito. Mr. Dudley Kaito, please.
Thank you, Chair. I do think behind this motion there is a bigger motion, which is, what is the purpose of Hong Kong U? I think we are all benefiters after years of competition, so I'm very grateful to be here. But however, we are sitting here and debating, but we also have to consider there are a lot of third grade students who are far from the doors of university. It's something so hard in there high school or higher diploma or associate degree. If we talk to them to say, we should be more internationalized, we should have more cultural exchange, so that, sorry, your place has been sacrificed. I'm sure you can get response in five languages. So here, we might not solve the conflict here, but what we can do is to be considerate of all partners. We are winners of the competitions, but we should have the empathy for those who cannot enter the university. So it will be always hard to strike the balance. There is a Chinese saying that, you yu hong zhen, ba na yin ba. So, you don't have to translate that. It's always good to have more programs before. I'd like to see more international students as well as more local students. But there's always a constraint. This is a cruel fact of the society. So that is so hard to convince by reason. So what we can do is to face this very fast situation with empathy. And this is the end of my speech. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And would Professor Chin or Dr. Avichal, you have some response? Okay. Dr. Avichal, please.
Thank you, Chairperson. Thank you, counselors and students. I'm very grateful for all the good points made today. A lot of very, very good, insightful perspectives have come out from this debate. But I would like, because our role here is to share information, so I will just share a few thoughts that CEDARS, colleagues in CEDARS as well as colleagues in the university are thinking about along these lines. We all agree that Hong Kong should nurture leaders, okay? And leaders are not just for Hong Kong, not just for China, but actually for the whole humankind. So for that, we would like to nurture students regardless of their background, okay, into global leaders, not tomorrow, indeed today, because there are so many global problems that we're looking at. So I hope that we will take that into consideration, and that is the common goal, and we can together work out policies, methods to achieve that goal. Secondly, Mr. Chair of the Social Sciences Society has already addressed the issue of equal opportunity. I also study social sciences, so equal opportunity or equality does not mean that everybody gets the same thing. When we are working with students at the university, we are blind to nationality, we are blind to gender, we are blind to their mother tongue, we are blind to everything. We look at students and we try to maximize the gain, the benefits of each one of them. Having said that, we don't mean that we are providing just the same thing for every student regardless of their age. For example, you take examination as an example. We have the same passing mark, we have the same examination of age. But when we have a student who is dyslexic, okay, who needs more time to read, then we give them extra examination time. That is the spirit of the quality. So as CEDARS as well as the university, we try to cater for each individual student's need, okay? That it may arise from his background, cultural background, that it may arise from his personal preference. Someone may like Western food, someone may like Chinese food. It is out of that mentality we are providing our support to students. We are blind to their nationality, we are blind to their mother tongue, we are blind to their gender, we just know that we are blind. And then finally, maybe we should not look at the issue as a serious thing. I get more, you get less. Of course, resources are always limited, as Mr. Lee said. But at the university, we are trying to maximize the opportunity for every student to achieve the very first goal that we agree on. That is, our students will be international, will be global leaders in the future. So we are looking very, very hard at, say, for example, how we increase our emphasis and change opportunities, how we increase our internship opportunities for all our students. And with that, I just want to share a few thoughts with you, how colleagues in the university and CEDARS in particular look at these issues, and hopefully there will be some insights, there will be some things, some actions that we can take together. Thank you.
say a few things? I'll just say a few things and then... I don't know about you, I'm very hungry. I haven't had lunch, so I'll keep it very short. It's a very impressive how the council runs. Very pleased. I'm also very pleased that there are a lot of students surrounding the green gowns. And I'm exceptionally pleased that there are a lot of international students who spoke up. I remember a student from Korea, one from Malaysia, one from UK, etc. So this is a good forum. I will be more happy next year if you invite me again. I hope to see more non-local members in the council. That will make Hong Kong U to be Hong Kong U and Hong Kong U to be a global university. Basically, the debate is about global university, whether Hong Kong U is an international university or not. And I think the motion is a little bit misleading. Every time we talk about is globalization, internationalization, but the title of the motion is very restrictive. And I don't like it, to be very honest. I think it's a little bit negative. I think it's a little bit divisive. I think it's offensive, inward-looking, and self-centered. But I'm not here to debate, I'm just giving you a comment about that motion. I think globalization is not about ranking, it's not about language, it's not about 20% of local, it's not about 50% of mainland and 50% of overseas.
Guilin, representative of architectural societies. And the second one will be Wong Chia, the external affairs secretary too. In first from Rosetta. Any consultation, discussion, amendments? All 40 members of the Union Council, please raise your hand. Please up your hands. ASR. For those who are for this motion, please raise up your hands. Please raise up your hands. President.
For Council Graves, then please raise your hands. The amount is not correct. All 40 members, please raise your hand. Please speak louder when you are counting. Please raise up your hands. For Council, who is against this motion, please raise up your hands. Against is 29, abstain is 1. Motion defeated.